हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द सेशन। वेलकम टू द सेशन ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर्स इन सी शार्प। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द सेशन, लेट मी जस्ट इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ। सो दैट इज माई सेल्फ गुरु, एंड माई ईमेल आई डी इज दैट इज गुरु मैट्रिक्स 2004@gmail.com, एंड आई एम अ सॉफ्टवेयर डेवलपर। ओके, एंड दिस इज माई वेबसाइट दैट इज www.questmon.com। डू विजिट माई वेबसाइट। Here you can find a complete videos on .NET, C#, design patterns, SharePoint, UML, WCF, WPF, WWF, Java, and lot more on .NET interview questions and answers. So do visit my website. So let's start the session. Structures in C#. So this is our agenda for today's session. That is, we will first see the definition on struct, and we will go and see the difference between the structures and classes. Then we will have a simple example on structures and classes, that is a demonstration on memory management, or you can say memory usage between struct and classes. So let me start with the definition part first. Structures are basically value types. A simple one-liner definition which says structures are basically value types. They are logically related, or I can say there are the group of logically related data items. Let me write as a one-liner definition, that is, structures are basically value types. They are group of logically related data items. And one more point, that is, structures do not complete object-oriented approach, means they do not follow the object-oriented programming, means they do not have polymorphism, inheritance, encapsulation, aggregation, composition, all that stuff. Okay. Yes. So since the structures are value types, they easily get allocated on the stack. So this is a simple one-liner definition of a structures. Okay. So now let's see a difference between structures and classes, because many developers get confused between structures and classes, means when to use structures instead of a class. Okay, because they both look very similar in terms of declaration. The only difference is the struct keyword over there in terms in the declaration part. So as I said, so let's see the differences. So structures are value types, whereas classes are reference type. So value types means they get allocated on the stack. Whereas classes, their reference type, means they get allocated on the heap. Value types, which holds the value in its own memory, whereas reference type holds the reference to an object in a memory. So it means when you use value types, use a less memory as compared to the reference type, because reference type use more memory. When you create an object of a struct, it will use less memory as compared to when you create a object of a class. So the one more difference is that structures use less memory, whereas classes use more memory. So on this differences, I have a simple nice example, that is source code example. And in this code example, we will demonstrate the memory management, means how the memory is more consumed by the classes and how the memory less consumed by the structures. I have the demonstration. So for that, I need to open up my Visual Studio 2010. So let me open my Visual Studio 2010. So here we go. So this is a simple basic form, Windows form application in C#. You can see a solution explorer here. I have a Windows form application and a class library. Now it's nothing, but yes, we are going to code. Okay, so let me code something. Let me first code for the structures. So let me just go public struct, let's say. Let me just code for the graph. Let me create a structure for graph, that is str so this is my structure graph. We will have in a graph we have normally have the coordinates, so let's create a coordinates also. So that is x and y are the coordinates. Let me just say public yes. So these are my x and y coordinates in a graph. So just let me debug this and check. So build is succeeded. Yes, everything is fine. Okay. Now what I will do? Now I will create a class now with the same coordinates, that is x and y, and we will give a nice name, that is a CLS graph. So let's create a class here outside the loop of the structure. I'm not creating a class inside the structure loop, I'm just creating outside the loop of the structure, creating a new class. So let's create a public class, that is CLS graph. Okay, this is my class. Let me have the same thing which I have in my structure loop. So I'll just copy paste this thing here. Nice, good. So we are done. So friends, what I did here, I created a structure here with the coordinates, a structure graph. In a graph we know that we have x and y coordinates, so I created that here as a x and y coordinates. In the same way, I just created a class for graph. So now we will see if we use a graph, that is structure graph, how much memory get consumed. If you use a class graph, how much memory get consumed. So for that, tracking of the memory usage, or you can say memory management, we have to track the memory management. So for that, I have something called CLR profiler. Yes, CLR profiler. You can also download this CLR profiler depending upon your .NET framework configuration. Okay, my .NET configuration is 4.0, so that's why I'm using this CLR profiler. You can get the CLR profile depending upon the .NET versions. Get that, just open up the CLR profiler. Depending upon your Windows means, if it is a 32-bit, go to the 32-bit. If it is a 64-bit, you can go to 64-bit. Mine is 32-bit, Win 32-bit, so I'll go inside the 32-bit. So inside here you can find .exe file, DLLs. Okay, so yes, now let me complete my code here. Let me go back to my Visual Studio, that is here. So this is my code. Now I have created a form here. It's a very simple form, basic form. I have only one button here. Okay, so first do the reference, just reference your class library here into the Windows form application. Let me just reference. Okay, I think I already have that reference, so I don't need to reference again. So yes, the class library is there, so I don't need to reference. So friend, okay, so now what I will do here inside the button click function, what I will do, I will create a for loop here for int I equal to 0 int, oh I'm sorry, it's I is less than equal to 100 into 1000 I plus plus. So we have a loop that is for loop with 100 into 1000 times it is going to loop from zero interval. So now inside this loop, what we will create here, or what we will do here, we'll just create a object for a class. First we'll go and create an object for the class. Let's see what happens. CLS graph obj equal to new CLS graph. So what I did, friends, here I created the object for the class graph. That's it. We have to do this much only. Nothing more we have to do. We don't need to go and point to the our x and y component. Just we have to create the object here. Just save it. Okay. Just build once. So build is succeeded. Let me just build this again. Okay. Now it's time to go to our CLR profiler. Yes, as I told you, you can download the CLR profiler depending upon your .NET framework version. Okay, just download it. Okay,